Hey everyone, Tankenstein here. In this video, I'll be reviewing the MKPZ M47G, or as I'll be calling it, the German M47. This is a currently Tier 5 battle rating 7.3 medium tank that exists as a premium vehicle for the German Ground Forces tech tree. It currently costs 8,200 Golden Eagles and comes with 15 backups. In this video, I'll be going over everything that you need to know about it, including its stats, how it plays, I'll go over its strengths and weaknesses, I'll give it some scores in several key areas, and then I'll give my final recommendation on if I feel this vehicle is worth purchasing or not. As always, please consider subscribing if you'd like more content like this, but without further ado, let's get into the video. To start, I'll place the stat card here on the side of the screen. Important things to know are its turret traverse rate, power to weight ratio, and its overall armament. Now for how it plays. Put succinctly, the German M47 is basically a standard M47, except that this comes with smoke grenades. This means that the German M47 has very good mobility, somewhat middling armor, a good but not amazing cannon, and an excellent turret traverse speed. Because of this, the German M47 is a great flanker, support tank, and can even snipe, due to the high velocity of its M431 Heat FS shells. The German M47 is a vehicle that rewards aggressive play, as it is quick, has a reliably penning armament for this BR, and can deploy smoke grenades in order to retreat, if need be. Unfortunately, it doesn't have the best armor at this BR, or even very good armor, and is in some ways mediocre in that regard, such as with its side and rear armor. Because of this, it can't take direct hits for most heavy tanks and expect to survive. Even versus medium tanks, survivability is a bit of an issue. This is solved to an extent when angled and at a distance, largely due to the decent-ish front turret armor, along with its unusual shaping. Otherwise, this isn't a particularly strong vehicle insofar as armor is concerned. Regardless, if you play to its strengths, being that it has a reliably penning cannon and very good mobility, the German M47 can do well in the aforementioned sniping, flanking, and supporting roles. Just don't expect to frontline with much success. Much the same goes for brawling, but at least the German M47 has an excellent turret traverse rate in order to make up for its other flaws, at least to an extent. Oh, and I guess you can base cap a little bit too. Now with that said, let's get to its strengths and weaknesses, and first for its strengths. This vehicle has two HMGs, one on top of the turret and one mounted coaxially. This will help tremendously in destroying aircraft and lightly armored vehicles, as well as tank modules. Second, this vehicle has an excellent turret traverse rate of up to 36 degrees per second with an ace crew. This is as high as many of the best top tier MBTs in game, let alone vehicles at around 7.3 BR. For its third strength, this features smoke grenades and smoke shells. Fourth, while it doesn't have the best post-pen damage, the 90mm cannon plus M431 Heat FS shells will almost always pen enemies, even those with heavy armor. Fifth, the M47 has good mobility due to a good power-to-weight ratio of about 17.5 horsepower per ton for this BR, though it has a meh top speed of 48 kilometers per hour. Sixth, it has a very good vertical cannon guidance of between negative 10 and positive 19 degrees. Seventh, this vehicle features a rangefinder and night vision. For its eighth strength, it has 5 crew members, which is fairly good at this BR and increases survivability. Beyond this, it features a good gunner's optics of 7.5 times. For its 10th strength, the M47 has a good reverse speed of 19 kilometers per hour. 11th, this also features commander's optics. And finally, it has premium RP and SL bonuses. Now for its weaknesses. The M47 has a very tall profile, which makes it a fairly easy and noticeable target. Second, while not outright bad, the armor on the M47G is not very good. It's possibly even mediocre at this BR relative to other medium tanks. That's just the frontal armor, as the side and rear armor are actually pretty bad on this vehicle, even when compared to the same types of armor on other vehicles. Third, similar to the effectiveness of the armor at this BR, the 90mm M36 cannon and accompanying ammunition options are somewhat subpar. They can get kills, but none of the types of ammo are outstanding. The M431 Heat FS will regularly pen the enemy with relative ease, actually, but has very limited post-pen damage due to the shell type and size. Conversely, the M82 APCVC only has 185mm of armor pen at max, but will do much better post-pen damage if it gets through. There aren't any many options that combine good post-pen damage and good armor pen values with this vehicle. Fourth, this vehicle has a very large and somewhat easy to hit turret ring. Much the same, the vertical aiming drive is gigantic and easy to destroy. Beyond this vehicle has a huge poorly protected engine that will make mobility kills against the M47 fairly easy. For its sixth weakness, the turret crew is absolutely surrounded by ammunition, leading to easy ammo rack deaths. Beyond this, it has a fairly large MG port weak spot on the upper glacis plate, and finally, there is a large commander's couple of weak spot. With all that said, let's get into how I score this vehicle. And first, for armament, I surprisingly give it a 6.5 out of 10. While the 90mm cannon and ammo options aren't all too great, as they aren't great with post-pen damage and lack overall versatility, they can still get the job done fairly well. I oftentimes find myself in the unfortunate situation of facing an American heavy tank where I can shoot one spot on the tank, possibly killing the driver, and then I'll have to shoot the cannon in order to disable its firepower, and then on my third shot, finally kill the vehicle outright. This is the reality of the M431 Heat FS. Because it's only 90mm, it will pen fairly easily, but lacks post-pen damage. You start getting much better post-pen damage with Heat FS at around 100 or 105mm plus. Unfortunately, the other options, such as the M82 APC-BC, lacks armor pen with only, again, 185mm at max, which makes it usable only when you know what enemy that you'll be facing next and can pen through it with no problem. Aside from these issues, the other features on the German M47 help to improve the armament substantially. First, the amazing turret traverse rate of up to 36 degrees per second is legitimately incredible and places a huge tactical advantage on the M47. Further, with two 50 cal HMGs, you'll also be able to deal with lightly armored vehicles, aircraft, and enemy tracks very easily. While the cannon itself isn't fantastic due to the aforementioned issues, the combined armament package on this vehicle is surprisingly great. I've gotten very close on a few occasions to earning a nuke with the German M47, despite its apparent misgivings. Next, for mobility, I give it a 6.5 out of 10. The overall mobility on the M47 is surprisingly great. While it sees a point reduction due to having a comparatively low top speed, it hits it fairly quickly, as it has very good acceleration due to having a very good power-to-weight ratio. This makes the M47 quicker off the line than most similar BR tanks, though it may be outpaced in the long run due again to its somewhat limited top speed. Regardless, this helps to make it very good off-road and will allow you to play this vehicle effectively, even as a flanker and a base capper. Next, for survivability, I give it a 5.75 out of 10. On one hand, the overall armor on the M47 is not great, but on the other hand, it has saved me more times than I ever thought it would be able to. This vehicle is a good example of why stat cards have their place in War Thunder, but aren't the end-all be-all. While the overall armor thickness on this vehicle isn't fantastic, even on places like the front of the hull and turret, it still holds up surprisingly well, especially at ranges and while angling. The front of the turret is somewhat oddly shaped, which makes it a tougher spot to pen. But of course, armor quality and thickness aren't the only things that go into survivability on a vehicle. In addition to these things, the German M47 has 8 total smoke grenades, of which are fairly uncommon at this BR, and also has a 5-man crew and additional smoke shells for the cannon. Again, it's not fantastic in terms of survivability, but the design and features of the German M47 should allow you to coax more survivability out of this tank than should otherwise be possible. Now, with that said, overall, I give it a 6.25 out of 10. While being somewhat on the lower end of great, the German M47 has enough secondary traits, such as a great turret traverse rate, smoke grenades, and even commander's optics that take the German M47 to the next level, even, again, just barely. It is just competent enough where it can hold its own in most situations, even if it takes a few shots to kill larger enemies. Overall, while it does have some noticeable weaknesses, none are so outright bad where they sink this patent variant. Now, with all that said, do I recommend the MKPZ47G for purchase? Well, I like it a lot, to be honest. While it isn't overpowered by any means, which I feel a lot of people look for when they purchase a premium tank, the M47 has plenty of good things about it for many people to enjoy and do well with. It's in a bit of a barren spot on the German Ground Forces tech tree, where it doesn't have much support from other vehicles to make a cohesive lineup. And while I would say to purchase the German M47 before the RU251, largely because of its higher rank, I would say that the German M47 is a good vehicle to purchase while on sale. This isn't to say that it's a bad tank, because it's not. It just doesn't have much around it in the German tech tree, which is, in my opinion, a strong consideration when buying a premium tank. Further, the Term 3 is a better vehicle in many ways and is a bit more fun, while also not being all too much more money and also having a better supporting cast for a good lineup. In all, while I do give the German M47 my Tankenstein seal of approval, I'll say to wait for a sale before purchasing this vehicle. It's both very good and very fun, but doesn't have many similar BR friends in its tech tree. Also, it only costs a few hundred Golden Eagles less than the TAM 2IP, which is an even higher rank than the German M47 and is arguably much more fun and versatile. That higher rank means that you can research a good amount more vehicles with the 2IP than you could with the German M47 without penalty, while also having a better premium RP bonus, though a relatively worse SL bonus. Just something to consider as I end this review. Now with that said, thank you all so much for watching. If you don't mind, please consider liking and subscribing as both those things help my channel tremendously. Additionally, let me know what you think of the German M47 in the comments below. Either way, thanks again. I'll see you all on the other side. Take care, everyone.